Well, one effect of the pandemic being felt at the hospital is a baby boom right now. Experts say in lockdown, pregnancies are actually on the rise. Still, becoming a mom during COVID times is not without worry, and soon-to-be or new moms are simply learning as they go. So joining us this morning with some guidance is Dr. Kecia Gaither, who is Director of Prenatal Services at New York City Health Hospitals. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really do appreciate your time today.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Good morning. So you're saying that pregnancies are up. I'm sure that that's stressful in and of itself. People going through this right now, given all of the health uncertainties.
Absolutely. It is definitely a baby boom going on. Definitely.
Okay. And there's a lot of questions about this vaccine and whether expectant moms should be getting it. What is your opinion on that?
Most definitely. I think the thing that needs to be understood is during pregnancy, it is normal for your immune function to decline. And certainly COVID, you know, loves those bodies where the immunity has declined. So for those moms who are pregnant, particularly if they have comorbidities, specifically like diabetes, it's really important for them to have the vaccine.
And even new moms too, you said the maternal mental health right now may be an issue for many people. You must be seeing cases of this. What can moms be doing right now if they're trying to navigate being a new mom and in some cases handling it alone as you know, you've been forced to separate from so many family members
Absolutely.
Who would normally support you?
Well, I think look into those things that you find yourself to be calming. Take a walk. Take a warm bath, some aromatherapy, and you know, just continue to do the things that you normally do with the social distancing, hand washing, and so forth and so on. One way to boost your immunity naturally is to indulge in those foods that boost immunity, such as onions and garlic, and vitamin D supplementation is very, very important.
Okay, so you would recommend taking supplements. What about for women who are currently pregnant too? You said you would recommend getting the vaccine, but what about maintaining health otherwise while pregnant?
Oh, most definitely. Fresh fruits and vegetables, water, you know, instead of a lot of sodas, lean meats, exercise, and vitamin D supplementation. Vitamin D has a lot of benefits for the body, particularly during pregnancy. Mm-hmm. It decreases the risk of preterm labor and certainly helps to boost your immunity in the time of COVID. There's a great website called powerofd.org, which gives information about vitamin D and a lot of other supplements. You want to get a level of 40 to 60 nanograms per milliliter, and it's helpful for your doctor to actually assess your levels, particularly if you're a woman of color. Women of color tend to have lower vitamin D levels simply because the melanin in the skin inhibits the production of it in the body.
Oh, wow, that's interesting. And complications have been on the rise during this time as well?
Certainly in diabetics. COVID seems to have a predilection towards diabetics. A lot of the very poor outcomes that I've seen have happened with pregnant women who are diabetic. So if you're diabetic, if you learn nothing from this segment, keep your blood sugars in control because it's very important.
All right, very good. And where can people go for more information?
You can certainly go to powerofd.org, and I have a website, www.kecciagaither.com.
All right, Dr. Gaither, thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you. Be safe out there.
Thank you, and you do the same.
Thank you.